seized. If you guys enjoyed the intro or enjoy what you see here, go follow SM_battle_stories on Instagram or get some work done yourself. What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today I have another WWE action figure set up for you guys, and it is SmackDown 1000 edition. As you see, Ric Flair right here wearing the t-shirt. But I imagine it will be a lot better than Raw 25. You know, Raw 25 drug on way too long. There was a lot of filler bullcrap in it. I think that SmackDown 1000 will be a ton times better than Raw 25. You remember Raw 1000 was amazing. I think that SmackDown Live will do even better here. You know, we got some epic moments that night. I think we're going to get some epic moments on SmackDown 1000. Hopefully they don't disappoint. I'm going in with zero expectations. That way I'm not let down in the end. But I did set up the entire arena here, guys. Not the ring, though, because of sold out. I don't want to give anything away, so we will not be going to the ring for this setup, but we will be covering the entire backstage area as well as the GM's office, guys. So let's go ahead and get straight into it. So if we start off in the GM's office, guys, you will see Kurt Angle, SmackDown Live ex-general manager Shane McMahon, current general manager Paige, and Stephanie McMahon. I think this will go down on SmackDown 1000 October 16th. I think that they will reintroduce Kurt Angle as the general manager of either SmackDown, or they'll bring him back to Raw on that night. I think they'll, you know, they'll bring him out and he'll be re-inducted as the general manager of either SmackDown or Raw. I just think that would be appropriate. You know, Kurt Angle was very influential on SmackDown. He carried it for a long time, and I think that they will bring him back specifically on that night. You know, that'll be a long enough break for him. By the time SmackDown 1000 rolls around, I think it'll be a great time to return him. So that is what's happening here. Shane McMahon, Paige, and Stephanie McMahon are reinstating Kurt Angle as either the current GM of SmackDown or he'll go back to Monday Night Raw. If we come back through the general manager's office, guys, you will see right here we have Shawn Michaels, AJ Styles, and Rey Mysterio. And what's going on right here, guys, as you see the legend Shawn Michaels, I think that he will definitely be present on SmackDown 1000. And the WWE champion AJ Styles is getting in his face, wanting a one-on-one matchup. Everybody wants to see that matchup, so that's what's happening right here. AJ Styles getting in his grill, and as he's getting in his grill, Rey Mysterio, who I think will show up on SmackDown 1000, I think he'll, you know, re-debut, if you will. I think he'll have his return match on that night. He's coming up to AJ Styles and saying tonight he wants a match. So I think that the WWE champion AJ Styles will go one-on-one with Rey Mysterio on SmackDown 1000. And I think that AJ Styles is going to retain his championship at Australia's Super Showdown. So that's why he has a WWE championship. I think he will carry it into SmackDown 1000. So that is the reasoning behind that. If you go just beyond there, you will see Matt and Jeff Hardy. Obviously, Jeff Hardy is on the shelf right now. He's been written off television as of late after that Hell in a Cell match with Randy Orton. Very nice matchup. You see brother Matt sort of stepping away, and he's comforting his brother in this time right now. So that's what's happening right here. They're sort of there for each other. The brother Hardy's right there. And yeah, I think that both men will be present at SmackDown Live or SmackDown 1000. I think that is a definite thing that is going to happen right here. If we go here, you will see Brock Lesnar, the youngest ever WWE champion for SmackDown, guys. You know, he is here. I think he will definitely show up SmackDown 1000. I think it should happen. You know, he was a beast for SmackDown, and he sort of put SmackDown on the freaking map after The Rock. So I think that Brock Lesnar will definitely be there. He's sort of pissed off. He's walking around the locker room looking for Roman Reigns, but he doesn't realize that Roman Reigns is the Universal Champion of Monday Night Raw, so he's sort of dumb there. But, you know, it's Brock Lesnar. What can you say? Over here, we have Brie Bella comforting her husband, Daniel Bryan, because Daniel Bryan lost to The Miz at Super Showdown, and Miz became number one contender. So Daniel Bryan's sort of sulking over here with his wife, and that's what they're talking about. What is he going to do now that he's not the number one contender for the WWE Championship? What will he do now? You know, he's sort of just going to his wife, figuring out what he can do. And just beyond them, the guys, we have the freaking reunion of Evolution. Obviously, this is kind of weird, you know, because they were Monday Night Raw stable. They were, you know, the big part of Monday Night Raw. But I say, who cares? We got freaking Dave Batista in the house, guys. Freaking Batista is returning to SmackDown 1000. So he's here with Randy Orton, Triple H, and Ric Flair. We're rocking the SmackDown Live t-shirt there. So all four members of Evolution are getting back together. You see them embracing there, all talking it up. So this is such a great moment. I cannot wait for SmackDown 1000 to see this happen. I'm guessing Batista will either attack Triple H or something. I think that they're going to set up his return. So hopefully we'll see Batista return. Rey Mysterio will both return for full-time. Little, you know, at least for the year of 2018 going into 2019. I would love to see that. If we go just beyond that, guys, we do have the rated R superstar Edge, and he's walking down the hallway here, guys, just sort of there. I think that Edge will definitely show up SmackDown 1000. I believe he did miss Raw 25. He was not in the building. He had to do, he was filming over in like a Norwegian country for his show that he films. So he was not there for Raw 25, but he will make it for SmackDown 1000. You know, he was big time on Monday Night Raw and SmackDown, but I think his bigger role was SmackDown. We go right here, and we have Hulk Hogan and The Rock. And I think that both of these men will show up. I think this is going to be the time that they finally bring Hulk Hogan back to the WWE. And what better way than to bring him out for SmackDown 1000. You know, he did return for a stint as Mr. America on there, and he had a short little run, so I think that he will return here. And The Rock. You can't have SmackDown without The Rock, guys. They're going to pay him big bucks. They're going to get him in there for that appearance on SmackDown 1000. And I think these men will interact with one another. And The Rock's just sort of staring at Hulk Hogan. You know, Hulk Hogan's flexing on him. And, you know, The Rock's saying, you better put those muscles away before I snap them off and shove them up your candy ass and turn that sumbitch sideways. So that's what The Rock's telling Hulk Hogan right here as, you know, he's flexing his stuff. And we go over here, we got Samoa Joe. And Samoa Joe's angry. You can see the expression on his face. He's real mad. You know, he lost his no disqualification match with AJ Styles at Super Showdown. That's my prediction here. And he's just frustrated. He doesn't know what's going on. So he's just over there pissed off with his towel, just sort of angry. If we go beyond that, we have The Miz and Maurice. And again, we had Daniel Bryan back here sulking. We got The Miz back here celebrating because he defeated Daniel Bryan. He is the number one contender for the WWE Championship in AJ Styles. That is my prediction for Super Showdown. We will be doing my Super Showdown predictions here in the next few days, guys. So be on the lookout for that. Going over here, guys, we have John Cena. And John Cena, he's not doing anything in particular because he is eyeing the one and only Undertaker in the very back. You got the Undertaker back there. He is eyeing the Undertaker because he knows that, you know, the Undertaker squashed him at WrestleMania, and he's just trying to figure out what can he do to get back at the Undertaker. So that is what John Cena's doing over there. He's staring at Undertaker, and Undertaker is staring at Shawn Michaels. So he's staring all the way across the arena at Shawn Michaels, and the reason that is happening is because I think at Super Showdown, during Triple H and Undertaker's matchup, I think Shawn Michaels and Undertaker are going to butt heads some way, and Undertaker is going to either end up losing or they're going to interact in some way, and that is going to make them fight at Survivor Series. It's a big rumor going around. I think it's going to happen, so that's what's setting up that little feud right there. In the middle here, we have the list. Chris Jericho, I think he will show up SmackDown 1000, and he's carrying around his list looking for more victims to the list. Cannot wait for Chris Jericho to return, guys. I think that it is time that he finally shows up. You know, we've been missing him here on SmackDown and on Raw, so we definitely need Chris Jericho back. I think he'll, you know, he had the moment of the night at Raw 25, so I think he can do it again and make the moment of the night at SmackDown 1000. And then to finish off our setup, guys, the second thing, we have Shinsuke Nakamura, the U.S. champion, just sort of staring around, doesn't know what he's doing. I think he'll have a U.S. title match on SmackDown 1000, you know, trying to add stuff to the card. So I think that Shinsuke Nakamura will have a championship match on that night. And then, guys, the final thing that I have on the setup is up here in the rafters, in the heavens right here. We have Eddie Guerrero, and he is looking down. This is sort of some symbolism right here, guys. He is not a part of SmackDown 1000, but I guarantee that they're going to give him a tribute of some kind, and he is there in spirit and heart. And I cannot wait to see what they do for Eddie Guerrero on SmackDown 1000, because you can't have a SmackDown 1000 without Eddie Guerrero. Viva la Raza. But that pretty much does it for this WWE action figure setup, guys. It's been a little bit since we did a setup. At least not anything to do with horror figures. I really enjoy the setups. They're really fun to pose around and see the moments that we can make with the figures. Again, I would show you the arena, but you know, we have sold out going on, and I don't want to spoil anything going on in there. But we are working hard on that show, and we're going to have it up as soon as possible, I swear. You know, the shows take a while. I'm filming it all by myself. I have to edit the whole thing by myself, so I am just going as hard as possible on that, trying to get it up to you guys as soon as I possibly can, and it's going to be an epic show. Best show of MDT by far. It's going to blow out Money in the Bank, it's going to blow out Blackout, and it's going to blow out every episode of MDT and Vindication, I promise. But that pretty much does it for this setup, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.